We're going to call the meeting to order. It's 5 o'clock. Roll call. Everybody is here except for Cheryl.
Cheryl's sick today.
Okay. Any additions to the agenda?
I just mentioned that we had a couple committee meetings that I hadn't put on the agenda. The West Central had that Lou will report on. Facilities that, being Cheryl's gone, Lou, you can report on, and I can fill in there just a quick...
That would be probably the most of it. You mean what?
The facilities and equipment one, we'll just give a quick update on that. And then Matt is going to give the Community Ed Advisory Committee meeting today, so Matt will talk about that a little bit.
Oh, okay.
So that would just be it.
Okay, all right. Okay, then move on to District 741 is proud of, the FFA horse judging team for placing third at regions and qualifying for state. Team members include Asia, help me with this. There you go, up there. This is what she said. Placing first, grade 11. Bailey Whaler placed ninth at grade 11. Emily Potter, grade 11. Brittany Demo, grade 11. And Matt Hartfield, grade 12. FFA parliamentary proceeding team placed third. Team members include Asia, grade 11, Megan Molitor, grade 9, Angela Molitor, grade 11, Donna Horn, grade 11, Evelyn McAdams, grade 11, and Brenda Bierman, grade 11. Anybody here for public comment? Okay. Move on to number 7. Approve and correct the minutes from the February 23rd, 2017 regular school board meeting. It was in your packet.
I'll make a motion we approve the minutes.
I'll second.
So I got a motion from Bruce and a second from Rick. Any other further discussions? Hearing none, all in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, and carried. Moving on to consent agenda. One thing underneath the consent agenda is review and consider approval of the following athletic assignments for the 2016-17 school year. And that would be the 7th grade baseball. Jeremy Ryder.
I'll make a motion that we approve the consent agenda.
I got a motion from Bruce.
Second.
Second from Randy. Any other further discussions? Hearing none, all in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, and carried. All right, business. We have Kelly Whaler and Lori Flora will be presenting information about the art program.
Okay. I brought the backup just in case my technical support doesn't happen. I'm loving to start.
You need to move?
Yep.
Kaylee, can I have you come down here?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I think you have a bunch of things, but Donnie can probably help you carry some of that.
She does have some video stuff that to show with, so if you want to see it, it might be that way better again.
Okay.
It's up to you. I'm here. I'm just around. My intention was, you know, it was going to be a beautiful video, and then the young gentleman that was putting it together for his project tried out a brand new camera. It didn't work as well as he was planning with the brand new camera. So we have little pieces, but I figured since he put the time in, we would show them.
Kelly, you couldn't move the mic or bring the mic over to the center, otherwise they won't hear you.
Sure.
Well on the table. Thank you.
So again, I'm Kelly Whaler, and I have to say that I am a very lucky lady. I teach middle school and high school art. And I have a lot of creative kids that walk through my door. And I enjoy every single day of working with them. So I thought maybe we'd start out first with some of the video clips and just show you across the grids. And I can tell you some of the things that they're doing. And then I can show you kind of what I was envisioning in the future a little bit and just talk a little bit about what I have here.
Okay. So what do you want to do? So you want to go sit up there?
Yeah.
Where do you want?
Might as well, everybody can see it.
Okay, and I'm not sure if she'll introduce herself, but this is an advanced art student that's working on a ceiling tile.
And then the next one. Oh, that's the same one.
That's the same one.
Yep. Okay. I'm ready to go here. We were supposed to skip that one, right, Kelly?
Speaking of her.
Hi, I'm Cindy Riley. I'm Rebecca Mulgar, and I'm Mrs. Whaler. And we're going to talk about the Banff Shoe Competition. Exactly. Banff Shoe Competition is a great competition to get students in. We've done it for the last 5 years, where Banff has developed four different varieties of shoes that have been to decorate various teams. And along with it goes individual scholarships and scholarships for the school that the kids can win depending on their design. So the four teams that we have this year are music, art, extreme sports, and local flavors. Becca has art, I have music, Sam Haynes has local flavor, and April has extreme sports. And we're really excited to kind of put our ideas on the shoe. And this is just an example from a couple of years ago. So the students stand up and sell the beginning of April, and then we do an official photo shoot with them too, and then we actually upload them to Bam, and then they go to a preliminary competition. And eventually, if the kids pass that one through Bam, then it goes into an online voting, which would be anybody from our school, community, that we would get activated into that kind of voting system. So we can move on to the possibility of a big event that would be in San Francisco in the summer. So,
three, two.
I'm Melissa Stone, this is Design 2, and this is our quarter project, and you have to finish. Quarter product is the quarter product, which we have to finish in like 5 quarters.
No.
Hi, I'm Alfie Gottwald, and I'm in advanced art, and I'm this is our final, and this is line decoration. I'm Lindsay Wander. I'm Raymond Swanwell. I'm the event center, and we did our latest project for 7th grade, a full speed estimate project for the soft testing. So we did a lot of day quick, and we did 7th club, and then we did visual hints about who they are. I did them all often. And then Trump.
A little political area.
Three, two.
Hello, this is our project. This is our ink making project. And my name is Good.
Thank you, Kevin. I'm a second.
I'm a liar. And for how we start, we take stamps like this, and then we use a tool like this and carve out our picture.
And we fix this and we roll it over, and then we put it on to our paper, and we'll get our final result.
Two.
Hi, my name is Wyatt Hoppenkamp, and this is our quarter project, our pen project. We are all assigned 1 pen, and it's supposed to empty it out. Just one sheet of paper. This is where you leave everything, and you have to use all the pens, the entire quarter to do it. You have to drain it, and you have to be very creative and a lot of detail.
Jared Dalton, Hunter James,
and for Molina Gutierrez, and the one
for the second one, you can do a bigger piece of paper, and then you can shoot that. And that's
what I'm doing. He's
just doing it. I'm doing
the guitar used by Luther Perkins.
Why is your joke?
One.
I'm Jackie Ryan.
I know her.
Yeah, I was going to say again.
And these are some of our projects that we work on for middle school dances that we complement. for our storage for Rob Tudo.
Hi, I'm Becca Mogard.
And I'm Ashley Einstein.
And we're here with the Paynesville High School Student Council. And we use this room a lot for various projects throughout the year for working on them and also for storage.
Good afternoon, I'm working for you. I'm out of lunch.
I'm out of lunch.
Preliminary steps, you can see there.
I think that was it for that one. If I cut them off, Kelly, let me know.
Okay. I think there's only two more.
Or that one's not going to work. We'll do that
one.
My name
is Brittany Gunther.
And I'm Spencer Brewer.
And we are monitoring one, and we are making holes. I'm sending my clay.
And right now I'm working on trying to build up the walls to play.
And after we get done centering them and all those stuff, we put them into the burner and they burn. And then we have to color them, and after we color them and reburn them, that's the outcome. And then behind you we have the reprocessing.
Hey, I'm Jordan Johnson, and I'm in advanced art and mixed media. And for the past, I'd say, 3 years, I've been working on in Photoshop. And if you see here, this is one that I worked on in sophomore year. And then from 2 years later, this is one I'm working on right now. It's our short film, and I'm just learning a lot more about it than anything else I possibly could.
Hi, I'm Brittany Gunther. I'm Mixed Media 1 and Music Photography Studio. We do stools and ceiling tiles, make holes on magazines, and stained glass windows, and t-shirts.
to throw at you, but that's all the stuff they got going on, and that's just this semester.
I know they briefly talked about band shoes, and I brought another one in. It's a great competition for the kids to get in. Not a lot of schools. You have to kind of register and hope you hit it. And for the last 5 years I have, and it's a good opportunity because 4 kids are allowed a pretty good chance at a scholarship for both themselves and the school based upon their designs. And plus it kind of puts them into coming up with a creative design that hits their theme. But then they also have to put together a photo shoot before we uplift them or upload them to fans themselves. So that's one of them. I know the kids talked a little bit about their finished pottery. Next in our mixed media class, we're gonna be doing school beautification projects. So we're gonna be doing a couple murals down in the office, and they also want a ceiling tile. And then there'll be other, we're doing some Project Lead the Way murals throughout the two classrooms as well. One of the other projects the kids right now have going, they have to show me something I've never seen before. So, origami swans made into a tree, kind of snazzy. Moving on over, Fire Built has been really great throughout the last couple years donating frames. Stuff that they would traditionally just throw away. So we've been kind of hoarding them, and so this particular semester, instead of a sketchbook and design two, they all picked out a frame and had to come up with something creative to do with it. So it's been really fun to see, because I've had boys that have woodburnt in there and maybe made family collages or just added different things to it. One girl kind of made a jewelry holder, so some of the interesting things. We did woodcut. I think some of you maybe saw this, if you saw the BNC. I'm a student that is very into wood burning. That kind of seems to be the phase of the last couple years. Looking at utilizing both the rooms, high school, of course, it's like your pottery. Any big projects, right now we're working on palette art down there, so we have 12 palettes that we're going to be painting. So some of them will be going to the elementary school and going into the nurse's office. And then some of them are going to showcase at the talent showcase here in April. And the kids are pretty excited about that opportunity. The other thing is we do a lot of our props for student council. Stuff gets stored there as well. And then everything else is pretty much ran out of the middle school. After last Friday, kind of saying where I'm going off into what I'm seeing in the future. Last Friday, we were at BBE, which was kind of fun to get to go around and see some of the new stuff. And actually inspired me, and I went right home, and much to my husband's dismay, I went right onto Amazon and ordered two 3D doodler puppets. So my mixed media, too, are actually going to be making Eiffel Towers. So I'm pretty excited about some of that other opportunities. And being at the elementary, I didn't really see them using the Chromebooks, but they did the, iPads down there. So it was fun for me to see them utilize that because it kind of gave me some ideas with slow motion videos and where I'm going to be moving next year. So that's kind of where I see the vision a little bit there with some more technology, and I would like to expand a little bit more to the Photoshop. For right now, I only have 3 computers that kind of do that. But it's still something where I can cycle the kids through and give them a taste of it because it's kind of a select few of kids that like to dabble in that. But that's my record. And what can I say other than I love it and I have great kids and a lot of really talented. You can think of some of your kids that still sees Holly's handiwork on up to this day. Because my son was trying to talk me into buying one.
Oh, you do a great job.
Yeah,
good job. I know I get to hear quite a bit with the kids with different programs and stuff after hours and stuff like that, and I always hear somebody talk about our great artwork throughout the whole building, and just they're at amazed and awe about everything that you've done. Now, how long have you been here with Paynesville?
2004.
Yep. Okay, so about 11 years, 12 mm-hmm. years, something like that. And every year it seems like you're just bringing it to the next level, and it's just really neat to see a teacher embrace in that and then also get the students embraced in the arts and stuff, because that is really neat, all those things that you guys are doing here. So
we're trying, and our goal, and Rick knows about it, is we have a bulldog statue, so our next big step into kind of housing it into the community is painting these bulldogs, you know, sculptures kind of based by various businesses.
Mm-hmm.
So we have 30 of them, so we would like to, after the kids theme it out, so I could, you know, think of the wishing well. So if they did one, and one would be there, and eventually once people get out and look in the community and actually can name where all 3 of them are, then maybe giving them free passes to like a sporting event or a musical performance or whatever we might have going on in the school, just to kind of get people out and about and mingling with the community and the school.
Mm-hmm.
So that's our next big undertaking, but kids are kind of excited about it.
That's great. Now for your facilities that you have at your disposal right now, how is that going in your classrooms right now for that? I mean, for space, for, you know, different types of things that we needed to be looking at in the future, for budgetary type things, and, you know, just where is art going, you know?
Well, like I said, I would like to see doing more, and I think they're talking about putting in a grant with like a 3D printer would mm-hmm. be something that I think would be pretty amazing to try. This is kind of the baby step, I figure, in the ways of it. And, you know, obviously, even just like Photoshop and stuff like that. But I think, you know, the slow motion videos and looking at different editing things like that is going to be something that's going to be more readily hands-on when we move to this one-to-one conversion.
Okay.
I see myself probably taking advantage of the fact that the iPads are going to be maybe a little bit more dormant because everybody's going to be using the other ones, and I see myself probably utilizing them more
mm-hmm.
because of the video capabilities there. So for me, I'm kind of excited about them.
Okay.
And that's kind of where I see some of it moving. And I liked the idea of, you know, getting some more stuff out in the community that we can do. But I know every year the kids come up with different things that is sort of interest to them, and we just kind of go and explore it that way.
Good. Plain cooking.
And I think one of the things on our wish list is another pottery wheel, I believe.
Oh, yeah. Always cooking.
So we'll have to work on that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Great job.
Well, those are some great things as the community, you know, pulls together with all kinds of different events and stuff like that. And, you know, with the way that your art is going, I can envision that you all have some big sculpture somewhere in the area. You know, the way that you are expanding on all your different arts things, I can just envision that there's going to be a sculpture or something that's going to be really neat in the near future. No, I'm never going to retire.
Well, I said I think the fun thing about it too is, you know, you think about the kids that are in the community right now, or in my school system right now, but it's fun when there's breaks, because I generally get about, I don't know, 5 or 6 that come back a year to show me still what they're doing. They're still creating art and they're still moving on with it, and some are taking classes just to explore a little bit more in college, and maybe if they aren't, they're doing something at home, and I find enjoyment in that, seeing that it's a lifelong thing that they're using, right. And maybe it's a little de-stressor or whatever it is, but it's good for them.
Whatever you're doing is great.
Well, thanks.
Thank you so much, Kelly.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Does anybody have any other comments regarding the arts here in public? Okay. Discussion about the March 1st, 2017 community meeting.
I think just that was put on the agenda just as kind of a reminder to the community. Certainly we have gotten the word out as much as we can for the community meeting. If the board is okay, I'll just kind of talk a little bit about the way that meeting will go. We will bring people into the meeting. All our guests will be put into tables. We're hoping 6 per table. At each table will be a sheet with ideas, and the board has seen that, of things that community members have already brought up or have came up last or 3 years ago when we had the other facility piece that failed the question. At each table, they'll then pick their top 6 items that they think would be the items that they would like to see us improve our facilities or build a new facility. That certainly could also be that they don't think we should do anything. You know, so there's really no set parameters to this. At each table, we're then going to take their top 6 items. We will categorize them, put them up on sheets. Then at the end, while we're tabulating all the information, they'll also get 6 dots, and they will use those dots then to put those dots on the ideas they think are the best ideas for the district. Once we get that information, then that will come back to the facilities committee, which then will make a recommendation to the board, and the board eventually will then act or not act on the recommendation from the facilities committee. So anything that the board would like to include in this discussion?
So I know that we talked about for young families and stuff like that we're going to be able to provide some sort of daycare.
There will be daycare for that meeting.
Okay.
If they just come into the lunchroom area, the cafeteria area at the high school, we will direct them from there.
Okay. We did have a meeting with the Blandon group, and many of them will be there to help. So they're going to be there at 5:00, I understand. Is that what we're setting up?
Yeah. And our intent is to kind of have a leader at each one of the
right.
tables
so
to kind of guide
to help it. With that.
Perfect.
Okay.
The only thing I found, I saw this on Facebook, but somebody assumed that the list that we put out was like, this is what we're limited to.
And
they were already upset because their thing wasn't on the list. So they'll be there, I know that.
And that's part of the problem. Whenever you have any kind of a list, right. people either assume that's all you're going to look
right.
at. But it was just a list of ideas
right.
to help the conversation start at the
right.
tables. That's it. That was the whole purpose of the list.
It's got the conversation started already.
Nothing. Nothing has been set or gone back to the facilities committee. That's why we're gathering the information.
Right.
I'm looking Wait. Forward to it myself. I think that I talked to somebody from Lake Henry Lions, and they had a meeting last night, so they all know about it. I see people all the time that are talking about it. So maybe we won't have enough room.
Well, we've, administrative team has talked about that, so if we run out of tables in the cafeteria, we will start moving into our classrooms, so we'll be set for that. That would be a great problem to have.
Yep.
Now, have we gone to some of the other organizations? I know we talked about that.
It's certainly been brought up at the Lions. I think that the principals have gotten it out to parents.
Okay.
So I think some businesses have been contacted.
Okay.
So hopefully it's got out. There's been two articles in the newspaper about the meeting, so we're hoping.
Was it you were going to go, Bruce? Were you me talking to some of the, like an industrial park area?
Yep, and I already talked to a bunch of those.
You did already, okay.
Yep. Most all of them are reading the newspaper, reading some of the stuff, so many of them know about it, but the ones I talked to that we talked about, I brought up before that, and I think we'll do okay.
Okay, and you've been inviting them and telling them, okay.
I would love to have a packed room. And other items, again, it was as much of a, just a reminder to the community of that meeting on March 21st, 6 o'clock, and we guarantee out by 7:15.
Mm-hmm. We're going to have some tours too, right?
There'll be a couple places for them to go. We're hoping there's not a set on, there won't be tours. Part of the problem is we're hoping for a big turnout. Mm-hmm. If we get a big turnout, a tour is very difficult to do. So there'll be a couple areas that Lori will open up at the high school for them to go take a look at. Might be areas that they might look at and say, this is really an area that needs to be remodeled or changed. So we'll do that, but we're really hoping that the turnaround between the time we get the six main topics from each table to written on paper and put up on the walls will not be that long. We're hoping to be able to do it quickly. We're going to use our Chromebooks to try to tabulate all of that information.
Just so if we open up rooms, it's not the rooms that all got issues with them. Because I've already been to some of that where it looks like a total setup job.
We're going to go to the rooms that are nearest to the cafeteria and are easiest for us to do.
Not the basement.
We're not going down in the basement. I will not put anybody in the wrestling room.
Okay. Well, I think we're pretty well set. There are lots of people still talking about it. I just had a call today on it.
Good.
So it's all on the surface for everybody.
Yep.
I think we picked a really good time, kind of between the sports. Mm-hmm. We're at the tail end of winter, but we really don't have spring yet. I think it'll work out really good.
Yeah, like I said, be great to have a fantastic crowd that evening to get all the ideas from community members.
And we're encouraging the staff too.
Our principals have talked to the staff.
Okay. All right. Well, I just think that this is such a big thing for our community and our schools to have as much input as possible from everybody, and I'd feel really bad if we had a very small group of people come in and support the school. I think that'd be devastating, I guess.
So. Well, if we get the word out to everybody, that's the best you can do.
Right.
And as long as we're sure everybody's aware of it, there's always going to be conflicts of some sort.
You know, the purpose is to gather information from the community. Mm-hmm. This is their chance to provide us with that.
And to have a voice, kind of in what they would
right.
like to see
right.
in their school.
And that's the biggest thing, because you know, we hear a seven on the board, and the administrators and the teachers and everybody that works in the community or in the schools know what we really need and stuff like that, but the public is the one that really needs to be aware of what's going on and really want to focus on. Yeah, they have to foot the bill. Yep.
Yeah.
Right.
If a facility project goes forward, they are the ones that get to decide it.
Right.
Yep. Good.
Okay. All right. Strategic plan update.
I'll just put the strategic plan on there, and then I think various people will speak to their areas. So. This is the strategic plan we had developed. And it has the belief statements here and the mission statement that we put together is prepare students with the academic, social, and personal skills to be career, college, and community ready. And then the vision statement is the Paynesville area schools pursuing excellence for tomorrow's challenges. And then we're just going to kind of talk about each of the two areas and where we're at for so student achievement.
I can address student achievement. I'm the data coach for both buildings as well as the district assessment coordinator, so making sure that we get everything in line. Some of the things that we said we were going to do is use the tools that are available to us to identify students early. I know we had talked about that a little bit at the last board meeting as far as how are we reducing that achievement gap and are we very successful with it. The one thing that is happening is even though the state is saying that we are going to do less mandated testing, they seem to give us more. And that is very, very frustrating for all people involved, the teachers, the students, and everything else along the way. We will probably see some adjustments to this as the new laws and the new administration are in position for the national level. Minnesota has prided itself in being ahead of the curve with everybody else, so we have some different things that are going to be there. The focuses are on our math and reading and being at grade level. And some of the things that we're seeing are that there was recently, Bob had just sent out an informational email that the Minnesota State College system is going to start using cut scores for MCAs to determine if you have to take remedial math courses or reading courses in college. So they're putting a little bit of teeth back into those high school tests. So we end up testing at grade levels 3 through 8, and then once in high school for math, reading, and science. We also have the ACT that shows college preparatory, or being at that college prep area. We have our STAR testing and our AIMS web that's used throughout. And it's one of the things that's been really nice to hear this year from many of the teachers, especially in the key curricular areas, is that we're doing things to move forward rather than kind of that one-shot thing. We're looking at it and we're addressing that issue and continuing forward on it. Will we see an immediate result? Probably not, because anytime you are testing a grade level that goes through in education, we know that our product is not done after 1 year. We're a work in progress. We're looking to see those steps and increments along the way. And we've put a lot of time into the student achievement piece as far as what we were using. And then the big thing that we've done is to make sure that instead of it being a plan over here and then doing something else over here and doing something else over here, we're aligning everything. So we're aligning the strategic plan with the world's best workforce plan, with the integration plan, and everything is coming together. So we're on one path instead of a bunch of little trails that go off beside it. So I think that and the key goal of reducing the achievement gap, looking to provide a variety of our opportunities in college and career readiness, we're making those steps forward.
I can kind of talk to kind of in that room as far as some specific things that we've done over here in the secondary building is both our math and our English PLC groups worked with Dawn looking at our last year's data, then really did spend a lot of time looking at the standards and then looking at what their curriculum is and reworked their math. Emphasizing some things and actually taking out some things because those are not what falls within the standard. So we hope to see some success from that alignment with the math and the English. Another thing is we did implement the Algebra 2A and Algebra 2B program to really give kids a chance to practice the math that they're teaching. And from talking with our high school math teachers, they really feel like they're having time to work with kids on each topic or each new idea instead of having to continually rush them to the next one in order to get to the end. So they feel good about that implementation of that. Our remediation reading program with our 6th, 7th, and 8th grades. We took the kids that are looking at being not proficient, that are general education students, and they are spending two times for 20 minutes a week with Amy Jo Gaby working on just reading in the area of reading that they're struggling with an independent program. So we have that going on with those students, and they are actually tested every quarter to see what kind of progress they're making. We're tracking and kind of developing independent programs for them with that information. So hoping that we'll catch those kids at that point. On a building level, our building level goal this year was looking at vocabulary and three specific strategies to teach vocabulary across all disciplines. Mary Leindecker did a nice presentation to our whole staff at the beginning of the year, and then we did another one halfway through. And they've been talking within their PLCs how that is working and how that's emphasizing part of that technical reading, that we'll see a lot of that in MCAs as well, and what they'll need out in the career is reading in that regard. So those are some of the specifics, along with what we had last year, which was the targeted services, which we started about halfway through the year last year. So those are kind of some of the specific things that we've put into place to help with that achievement, and now we just hope that that will show some growth as we move forward.
So in some of those where you have that testing as you go?
Yes.
So are we getting better?
Yes, we are. Okay. We're showing some positive growth. And those are numbers that, if I didn't know how detailed this report was going to be, that I can share those reports in general the next time.
Well, when I look at the strategic plan, we need to be moving forward, but it has to be something in document. Mm-hmm. So if in Don's case where it doesn't show up for a few years, nobody's going to buy that. I don't buy it.
Yeah, and at the end of the year, we can show that, or I can show it.
Yeah, we just need to see some improvement somewhere.
Yeah.
Because I bought some of the programs, and I happen to have an 11th grader right now. And so I talked to him quite a bit about talking to his instructors and that type of thing. And he had an instructor first half of the year that just say he needs to stay here. Well, when he told me that, I thought, well, then they must have it all figured out. But it didn't show up in his tests. Okay? So maybe it's him. Maybe it's not. But I don't think he's the only one. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Where he goes to the next person, and he actually said to me that has an instructor that wants to see him be successful. And even though he doesn't have a lot of time, I always take time to make sure it moves forward. Well, that's just mine. Mm-hmm. But everybody's got one. Every parent's got one. The kids have to be moving forward somehow.
I was going to speak on a couple of the objectives from the elementary standpoint. 1B with the extended day services that we've been doing that for a few years. We currently are doing the math. We do Bulldog Enrichment, which is after-school math and reading program, and we have 50 students that are signed up for the math, which is on Mondays from 3:05 to 4:30, and reading on Thursdays, the same time, we have 42 students. Some of the students are in both. And then we also have our morning team, which meets from 7 in the morning to 7:45, and we have 13 students that are involved in that. And there they're working on social skills and specific math and reading skills also. And that's on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. And then a small part of it, which I think gets overlooked a little bit, is the PAWS program, because there's a lot of students there and they do have an opportunity for enrichment, and they have opportunity to work on some homework or do some things like that. But that's really been a really key component for us too, is to provide that socialization and the enrichment after school with that program. 2B in the objectives, or 2A, I should start with, and that's our Reading Well by Third Grade, and that's a report that I put together each spring, and that's posted on our website. And as far as the annual targets for increasing the number of students who are reading at grade level, and we base that every year on our MCA test that the third graders take, and then that data gets to us at a later date. 2B, K-12, pre-K-12, we use the curriculum cycle that we've developed, and we use data from assessments and benchmarks to adjust our curriculum and that. 4A, on the other side, in student support, we work in our PLCs and staff developments, and we're looking at data and assessments, and we work closely with Don, K-12, to adjust and try to be proactive in our curriculum and in meeting the standards. And then 4B and 4C in the objectives, just kind of reiterates a little bit what I talked about with the work that we do with our PLCs. With QCOMP this year, we've really set a good tone with our PLCs and the amount of time that we're spending, where staff have the opportunity to collaborate, whether it's in department or grade level or cross grade level. And so that's really been a big step for us. We have our, there's staff development committees, there's elementary has a leadership committee, and so we're always looking at things as far as the curriculum and how our students are doing. And with our curriculum cycle, we have it built in there where we research, we implement, and we monitor on a 6-year cycle. And that's about it for student support.
Laura, you want to answer?
Yeah, I can kind of go on into student support. We focused a lot here to start on the career readiness, entrepreneurship as we kind of started, is working with the technology integrationist and faculty in that technology area. We're revamping the computer program on that 6-year cycle. It is the technology curriculum time in foreign language. So they are in that process now, along with the one-on-one initiative that we're doing now. So we'll see that as we move into the spring. We have also looked at revamping our exploratory foods program to be food chemistry in the ag area with the changing of teachers, but also looking at reinforcing those science standards that we're being tested on in the 11th grade that we've taken. Natalie Utch has looked at those science standards and put them into now a foods program. So it'll kind of hit both, one being the elective, but revamp of those the science standards, so hopefully those kids will transition that and do better on the testing, so they'll hopefully we'll see that. We have also looked at partnershiping more with the businesses, and you can see that with we've had a field trip for our career in tech ed students, both to St. Cloud Tech, the same program that we took all our staff to, which I think has been a phenomenal success because I'll hear them talk about it in the classroom, etc., and just relate different topics there. We took our career in tech kids to it and opened it up to kids outside that area. We have a iPad, and we have a RotoChopper field trip in the works for the spring. We did get, I talked about our last meeting, the approval for the apprenticeship, and I talked to three different businesses at this time, and that's going to hopefully continue to grow with opportunities as we get students involved. Hopefully that program will continue to grow. And this Friday, if you are bored and would like to come and visit us, we have our Ag Career Day that will be going on all day, where we have several different businesses and our FFA alumni have put together a fantastic day that we're bringing in outside businesses to talk with all our eighth graders. And then we continue to do a lot of the different things like our Ridgewater Career Day. We take all our 10th graders to. We do the college fair with all the 11th graders. And coming up toward the end of this month, we have all the different post-secondary opportunity options coming in to talk to our 11th graders as well. The students did take, our 10th grade students took the ASVAB, and we had their speaker come in, and he did a wonderful job. It wasn't military-based at all. It's like, let's look at your scores and your career aptitudes, and what are the different kinds of careers, and spent an hour of time with each of our students looking at that. And it was, I sat in on one of the sessions, and he did a wonderful job. I felt very good about that. We also offered the ACT, which has a similar piece to it, so we'll see when kids get those scores back if they have the same career option available to them that they have in past years. I don't know if that has changed or not. So that's some of the things that we've done to kind of look at that career readiness opportunities, bringing some of those things into our building as well as students out of our building to kind of open their eyes to what they want to do as they leave us and what they're preparing for. So still a lot to do, but I feel like we've started.
One thing that we do in activities, some people already did it, but we implemented it this year, where each team would bring some outside speaker in. A number of them did, like former players, and either how the sport helped them, whether it be the individual that came back and spoke to the cross country team, joined a club down in Mankato, a triathlon club, and that's how we got to meet people and participate. And build friendships and relationships, and so we're just tracking those. So we have a list of them and show. But other people actually, the volleyball program had a person come in to talk about goal setting. It had nothing to do with volleyball per se, but then related it to volleyball. So our programs are doing those. That's in student support. Action step 3C, I think, is what it is. I don't know if the action steps are on there or not, but.
Anything else on the student support for now? Okay. Finance. 5A has reached 8% unassigned fund balance. By 17-18, I think we're moving in the right direction to that. I think we'll reach our goal, but I would remind the board that we do have negotiations for all our groups this year, so I'm not quite sure yet how that will have an impact on that, but I think we're in much better shape than we have been in regards to our finance. Annually develop a 1 to 3 year financial plan that includes projected expenditures. We're doing that right now. You know, that's the piece that we always put together this time of the year. We have to have it done by June 30th, get it to the state. You have to approve our budget by then, so that's being developed at this point. So by June 30th, we'll do that. I think we need to, Max and I annually evaluate the student fees. That'll come to the board. That usually comes to the board before school starts, if there's any changes to the fees. Meet with facilities and equipment, and I'm looking at action steps now. Meet with the facilities and equipment committee. We're doing that now. We have another meeting set up for Monday, and hopefully we're hoping that that'll be our last meeting for that, but it depends on kind of what we run into that one. Both our 10-year and our 5-year plan both come to the board for approval. So once we get done with that, we'll bring that forward to the board. One of the pieces that we had talked about was to collaborate with community members. We did do that. Matt was good enough to put together a Paynesville leadership group that's met a number of times. We met in September. We talked about that. I do need to bring up a much more focused group now. We did have some people volunteer to be part of that committee. So now we have to put another committee together to, I think, probably narrow the focus more. We kind of had a wide discussion at that point, but a more narrow focus on what we need to do to improve our enrollment and what we can do to change that. So we still have some work to do on that one. Let's see, review and adjust the financial plan to support the goals established by the strategic plan. We're just getting to that point now. The principals will be talking to their staff members to see what they feel they need, both at the elementary and at the secondary level. But again, there are constraints that we have to work within our financial budget for that. But that will be taking place pretty quick here. Annual review and adjust the financial plan to support those goals. Again, as the principals meet with groups, you know, we'll still have staff development committee meeting, we'll talk about that. Do we need to increase that amount? Can we afford to increase the amount for staff development in other areas? And again, the principals will be talking to their curriculum areas. And remember, we do have a curriculum cycle, so a lot of those items are met on a six-year cycle for that. Any questions on the finance piece? I know with the financial committee, we need to meet to just talk about what has happened so far this year. And then as I get closer to it, and I'm a little behind on that, we'll meet two times, one to talk about how this current year's budget is going. Although we're getting to the end, I think it's been working the way that we intended it to work. But then we also need to meet as I develop the new budget for next year. Then we'll meet before it goes to the full board. So we'll meet, we'll discuss it, get any questions they have answered, and then it'll come to the full board for approval as far as finance. Okay, any questions on that? Okay, Garrick had meant to be here today to kind of go over the technology, but he gave me some ideas. 7A, which is to hire a full-time technology integrationist. Well, that's Garrick, and that one's completed. 7B is create a technology survey to assess the needs of the students, faculty. That's been done. They've already looked at that. That's part of what happened during the one-to-one initiative and where we came up with. District technology committees consistently and constantly talking about the needs as far as program and instructional technology in the district. So that goes on every day. Mark is part of our technology committee. He hears those discussions about what's needed. Right now, one of the good discussions that we're having at this point is smart boards. There is new technology out there. Do we need smart boards? So that whole piece is being discussed with the staff. In fact, I think he has a survey out right now to staff members about that. So that's being consistently looked at. 7D is address the Wi-Fi adequacy. Remember the E-rate dollars that we got? All of those dollars went into increasing our Wi-Fi in the district. And at least at this point, I've not heard any complaints. It seems to be working just the way that we had talked about it being put in place. And the technology committee, or district technology plan, is going to be looked at our next technology meeting, which I think is coming up not too long from now. So that one, we still need to do some work, but I think everything that we've done is kind of leading up to the development of that plan. Questions on technology? Okay, it's kind of update on that. Max, do you want to talk at least at all on the facility piece, or want me to keep going?
Well, yeah, I just had a couple of on technology. Garrick and I do meet quarterly about ways that we can implement technology within the activities and how we can use students to do that. Kelly had mentioned about with the Chromebooks, the iPads being available. We actually have availability to allow teams to use the iPads this year for doing things, which was nice to be able to do so. We meet on that kind of seasonally, so we'll actually just be meeting next week to talk about what can our spring activities benefit from the technology use. From the facility standpoint, action step 8C was gym space. I do have documentation. I brought it to a couple of facility meetings and never got to it as far as like square footage of gymnasium spaces with area and conference schools. It's a constantly changing. I just had a meeting yesterday in New London Spicer. They got walls going up for a big auditorium and they're adding on to their gym, which is larger than ours right now. Doing some classroom stuff over there, and I know holding forward at Piers. Piers has a boat coming in March, and holding forward is going through some of the same stuff that we are right now in designing projects and stuff. So all of that is just a constantly changing, but I do have some of that information. That's action step 8C in the facilities area. So obviously you guys are well aware of the meeting that we're having March 21st. I've spent a good amount of time talking about ready.
And I think that would be just AC, which is really to develop that plan, and we'll let the meeting go, and then that information will go back to the facilities committee. As far as 8A, it's really about safe environment. We certainly have, I think, corrected and put in place in the elementary school with the new way that everybody has to enter that building. I think that's worked pretty well. We have put the camera system in place at the high school. They have the buzzing system both at the main door and at the community ed door. I think we've taken care of pretty much the needs, although there's a, we found a few places.
Five spots that we will need to add a camera, because the camera view is just so long, we end up with a dead area, so.
And we knew we'd run into that.
Until we actually got the cameras installed, so it's not too much of a surprise.
So we'll add as we need to for that, and I think we're gonna have to hurry, because I think we need to be out here in a few minutes. The camera systems, I think, are taken care of pretty well. Develop five-year maintenance plan, we've already talked about that, that's part of the piece with the finance piece also. And that's really, every year, Donnie does a custodial support needed piece with that. I'm assuming he'll continue to do that.
The last time I spoke to you, I had the steam traps in elementary school inventory. I just finished up the middle school, high school, had them all inventory. My next project is going up on the roof and numbering the fans, checking for motor size, belt size. So everything is in a book, and where we don't have to run up on the roof, check it, and then come back down and get a belt. We can just run up and change it. Next month, I have the Tremco company coming out, a roofing company, and they're going to walk our roofs and map it out and see where to assess our biggest problems. Middle school roofs are now 24 years old, going on 25, so that'll be our next roof issue. Other than that, I guess we did create the online repair request process, which is working out very well. There are some teachers that are shying away from it, but trying to get them.
Can I just add something to 7C on the technology?
Do it quick.
Okay, I'll do it really quick. Is looking at the programmatic piece of it, is taking the staff to DDE to see what they're doing with the one-to-one initiative we did with the secondary building, which was very advantageous on so many levels. And then Garrick is also looking at doing a district-wide K-12 grant through the Paynesville Community Association that is looking at, like, for Kelly's got some 3D pens on that, and just some different spheros and coding things, different things that we can utilize across the district for teachers to use. So that's part of that, supplying the different softwares, etc.
These are kind of on a tight one. I'm going to recommend to the board, because we have to be out by about 6, if we table our reports, the principals would come at the first meeting in April, and we put the other reports on for the next meeting in March.
Sounds like a plan. Okay, so I got a motion to approve the informational reports. Okay,
second.
So I got
we'll table informational reports. The principals will be on the first meeting in April, and the rest of the reports will come in the second meeting in March.
Okay, so I think Bruce made a motion, and then Rick made the second. So all in favor by moving those reports, signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, and carried. And then our next one, Lou.
Motion to adjourn the meeting.
Okay. So I got a motion from Lou. And a second from Heidi. All in favor, signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign, and carried.